introduce Alexander Aring from Wiesbaden, who will talk about the low-power IEEE 802-something-15, I forget.
802.15.4.
That's it. And about what's new in that subsystem. So a big hand of applause for Alexander.
Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to my presentation about what's new inside the Linux IEEE 802.15.4 subsystem. So first I want to demonstrate a little demo here. I set up two virtual machines. And each have a USB transceiver, IEEE 802.15.4 USB transceiver connected. And I ping between the nodes inside the virtual machines. So that's an example. So it's a very high load ping, 8,000 bytes. You probably don't want it because the round-trip time is over a second. So it's very low weight and low. That's also because low power and such thing. But it's only to show what's possible to use the Linux stack. So if we show the interfaces, we see a low pan interface at the button. I can move it a little bit higher than the behind people can look at it. So the VPAN interface is the real IEEE 802.15.4 interface, which sent the IEEE 802.15.4 frames. And on the top, we have the low-pan interface that's for making the IPv6 stuff. So this is not only a virtual interface and internal kernel mechanism translate the IPv6 into 6 low-pan. And if you look to the Wireshark, I have opened two Wireshark windows. And this one is for the VPAN stuff. So the raw 802.15.4 stuff, we see a lot of low-pan frames because we have the high load ping. And in the fragmentation header, we see in the 6 low-pan, it's fragmentation header because the MTU size is big enough. And then on the low-pan interface, we have the plain IPv6 view. So that's translated 6 low-pan into IPv6 layer. So we see the IPv6 fragments. So we have also a fragmentation over the fragmentation. So at first we have IEEE 802.15.4, 6 low-pan fragmentation, and then we have IPv6 fragmentation, but that's only because it's was so high load ping. So another example is I have here a Contiki node, and I want to show on the IUDP example, so the LED is blinking now. And when we look to Wireshark again, then we see on the raw interfaces, on the VPAN interface, the raw 6 low-pan view. That's for example, and we can see here the UDP header compression. I will show you more about it later. So we see I used a special port range to save 2 bytes or 4 bytes. I don't remember. So introduction. Now let's start the presentation. Important new project updates. The last year I told the name was Linux Zigbee, but we don't name the project Zigbee anymore. We are now Linux VPAN, and we have a new mailing list that's hosted on kernel.org and a new website, vpan.kernel.org. And currently, we have a soft system rework in process because this was the current subsystem was not very nice to use. And this contains a Netlink framework, NL 802.15.4. I will talk later more about that. And we have a crypto layer, but we can't nice access this crypto layer. So we have support for this, but we need to access this from user space. So we need to add more support for this. And the frame parsing and generation is more very data frame time specific. That means we have different frame types, like wireless. They have also different frame types, and we need also pass and generate some beacon frames and command frames and so on. So the new frameworks about the rework. The basic idea is cherry pick the good things from the wireless stack. So you also all know the wireless implementation in your notebooks. If you're on Linux on it, then you have default a VLAN interface. So we have also a default interface naming if you connect a 802.15.4 transceiver, and it's registered as VPN. So in wireless, they have also different interface types. So that's the station at default, but also there is access point and monitoring and such devices. And we have also different framed interface types, like a node and monitor for promiscuous mode. And later we want to support also a coordinator interface type. So we also take the stuff from the user space tool, IV. You can type IV in your notebook if you have Linux with wireless support. And we grab this, the same tool front end. This is a whole framework for easily add new commands. And we name it just IV, and then add a pan behind. And we grab the the Netlink kernel framework. I will talk later more about this. It's named 802.11, and we just replace the 802.11 with 802.15.4. And also, wireless have the same paradigm, like doing soft and hard MAC interfaces. So transceivers can be accessed by making more hard MAC stuff on the transceiver side, or doing the soft MAC, doing it on the kernel side. So that's different kind of transceivers which you can buy. And what exactly is? I will show you just the IV. So I type the IV. That's the normal wireless command. You can see set frequency, name, MCAST, rate, and so on. And we just type now IV pan, and it looks very the same. It's just with 802.15.4 functionality. So we it's very easy to add new commands on it, but we have not many. And I also type here IV pan, IV pan phi, and that's also available in wireless, and to show all registered phis and def for all registered interfaces on the corresponding phi CO in this case. And we have also some MAC settings like short address, extended address, type, which I already know, and the pan ID and such things. You can also set these parameters over this tool. So we do this all with NL802.15.4. So what is NL802.15.4? NL802.15.4 is a kernel space Netlink framework. Netlink is a socket communication between user space and kernel space, and it's used mostly for configuration stuff, like setting frequency and address things. And the goal of the new framework is to have a framework which allow us to easily add new netlink commands to access this from user space. And why we add this is the code looks almost the same like wireless. So wireless people get easier familiar. And it's an already well-established framework. And we hope we getting more the wireless community from the 802.11 for 802.15.4 IoT use cases. So that means you don't need to put 802.11 transceivers into each smoke detector or such else, which is more cost, more power, and such thing. Then you can also use 802.15.4. So a code example, that's a calling chain from user space shell onto the kernel space. And this example shows the PAN ID. And I colored the relationship between each flag. So, for example, here the CIB netdev, and it's a required dev. And then we have in the kernel space implementation also a flag need netdev. So you need to type dev from the user space side. And it's pretty the same like wireless does. The green one is for some callback functions to set and get the netlink attributes. So that's the PAN ID number in this case. So another framework is in 6LoWPAN, which is our upper layer for making the IPv6 stuff, is the next header compression. And what is the 6LoWPAN next header compression? Also, the 6LoWPAN RFC describes compression formats. That's also for IPv6 compression header. And also for the next header. The next header is, for example, transport protocols like UDP, or also the IPv6 header extensions header, like hop by hop or routing header. And the NLC framework is pretty simple because it's a kernel module describes one compression format, for example, UDP. And it has two callbacks for making uncompression and on the compression. And but only NLC UDP is currently available. I demonstrated here. I type ls mod to list all loaded modules. And we see the NLC UDP is here. And a lot of other NLC, I told that UDP is only support, but the other ones are only there because for registration the IDs. And if you're using in your network hop by hop, it will show a warning. You probably should implement it or don't using it in your network. So for now, I want to make unload the NAC UDP compression. So we have no UDP compression anymore. And start again the contiki demo with the blue LED and show what Wireshark displays here. And we see in the 6LoWPAN header, we don't see any next header compression anymore. It's just a plain UDP header. So future work is for IEEE 802.15.4 is to remove the old netlink interface because we grabbed now everything from wireless, and that's pretty better. And implement the still VIP rework parts, which I mentioned before, and more MAC functionality. That's, for example, coordinator support and management layer triggered by netlink. What this means is the IEEE 802.15.4 standard describes also some scanning for PANs. And we just making the whole algorithm for that in the user space. We just implement some netlink configuration. And then we trigger only the algorithm by ML, a management layer scan netlink callback. So this is just like wireless is also just for scanning access points. And for 6LoWPAN, the configuration interface for NHC, what this means is we need some also some netlink interface for next header compression, because for UDP you can decide if you want to add a checksum or a lighter checksum, but this is only at the moment very default that it's always added the checksum. And implement, of course, more NHC modules. There's a quite a lot RFCs outside, which describes next header compressions. So summary, what I told you in this talk is what we grab from the wireless stack. And if you, it's pretty the same, what I told you also for the wireless stack, how they deal with netlink. And we just kept the ideas from it. So you can do now visit the vpan.cakelab.org website, and we have some table on it with supported hardware for 802.15.4 transceivers, and get the 802.15.4 standard. Set up some test environment is also described on the website. And possible hacking tasks are, as a newbie, start simple tasks like the standard describes a lot of numbers, but they also have some proper names for it, for like CAA mode. One is ALOA or something else for collision avoidance. And finally, you can become a wireless guru. And if you are that, you can look for similar paradigms in 802.15.4 and 802.11, and friendly copy the solution from the wireless subsystem. So then we grow more together to making more free stuff. And it's very easy to handle in both subsystems. So, is there any questions? Yes?
Are there also ideas from 6LoWPAN that could be used by the wireless subsystem?
So, the question was that 6LoWPAN can also be used in the wireless system?
No. So, you now copy ideas from the wireless subsystem into 6LoWPAN?
The question was that we also grab ideas from the 6LoWPAN wireless implementation into IEEE 802.15.4 wireless implementation.
No, if there are ideas for the 6LoWPAN from the 6LoWPAN implementation that can be used by the .11.
Okay. If ideas from the wireless implementation. 6LoWPAN implementation can also be used in the wireless implementation.
Yeah.
Okay. No, because because 6LoWPAN is need to be specified. So there's two RFC outside for describes as 6LoWPAN over 802.15.4 and for Bluetooth Low Energy. So that's only the two. Layer 2, so, which are specified to run 6LoWPAN on it. So maybe you can do some stuff there. Yeah, but that's not real a standard then.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry, but my question is very stupid. But does this, like what you're saying is that what used to be Zigbee is not actually available as kind of in quotes Wi-Fi in Linux. Is that the conclusion? Is that the
to using Zigbee? Inside Linux is because Zigbee is a closed standard and there's some.
Okay.
You can probably run Zigbee in user space, but then you need more better access to the Mac layer.
What's the best hardware to play around with it at the moment? What's the best hardware that is available?
Okay, the best. Okay, the question was, what is the best hardware? So I work myself with the 8068 RF230, and there's a lot of Atmel transceivers. That's probably the best hardware we have is on the website, but a lot of current mainline drivers doesn't support everything to set up promiscuous mode and such thing, but the ATRF230 support the most of it. Okay. Yeah.
There is a thing already passed RFC for 6LoWPAN on Bluetooth low energy.
Yes.
Any plans around it? Will it be easy?
Yeah. It's already. Mainline.
Okay.
It's just the RFC for Bluetooth low energy 6LoWPAN referencing the 802.15.4 RFC for the header compression. So we did some sharing code because it's almost the same, just for Bluetooth have I think not a 8-byte MAC address, I have 6, and then need to fill up the address. And for the next Bluetooth specification 4.2 is 6LoWPAN that's integrated. I heard that it's integrated in the transceivers and such feature. Yes? Can you repeat the question?
Yeah, if you plan to make data export
yes.
Easy, like for example, exporting in JSON format.
And in JSON?
It has this problem of that cannot be scraped. When you run IW on the 802.11, it says, please don't scrape the output of this program because it will be unstable.
It's a command line utility output. If you want to script it or something,
yeah.
So that, but that's the same for IWPAN. So that's mostly copied from there. So I think at the moment there's no stability there or something. So it would be the same problem you have there. So at least that's what we have right now. So.
Okay. More questions?
Okay.